Impressionistic style focuses on capturing the atmosphere, mood, and fleeting moments of everyday life rather than a precise, detailed representation of subjects. Hi, it's Peter here, and let's get right into the business. Impressionism is a style of photography that captures the fleeting moment of light and color in a scene. Soft focus, blurred edges, and a painterly quality characterizes it. I was talking about the importance of emotions in this video, where I was talking about how hard it is to achieve certain type of images because we are so keen on just visually pleasing images that has only a surface and they're not very deep. And that got me thinking about Impressionism, which is all about expressing your feelings and showing things in a different way rather than just the exact subject sharp and clear. So it is all about evoking emotions, showing the feeling that arises from something that we see. It's not easy, but I think that's the essence of photography, especially if we're doing street photographs. As I said already, that we tend to photograph just pretty images without any feelings. We need to go deep, and I do have a video about that subject too, so you might want to watch that after this video. I will have it on the end screen too. And before we get into seven things that help you make impressionistic images, this is also the assignment for next week in 52 assignments. So I hope this video helps you to make great images for that assignment next week. And now the seven tips about impressionistic photographs, or how to make them when you're doing street photography. But of course, this applies to any genre. Focus on light and color. Much like impressionistic painters, photographers may emphasize the play of light and shadow, the vibrance of colors, and how these elements change throughout the day. Yeah, this is the big point. Try to show your emotions and your feelings through light and colors. And those are both really important parts of photography. Well, color not that much if you're doing black and white, but light and shadow. So try to find light and shadow in your images to make images a bit more abstract. And a tip for this: learn the place and check out how the sun is shining, which direction, and try to follow that and see where the big shadows are or where the light will emphasize the color. So checking out the direction of the sun where you are and picking the time to photograph according to the placement of the sun is a good way to make it easier. So it's not just random, you know kind of where you're going, and that, you know, planning your photo walk, looking how the sun shines on different areas during a day. Movement and blur. As I already said in the beginning, that a photograph doesn't have to be sharp and clear. In impressionistic approach, you can have blurry images, motion blur, unsharp images, just to, you know, like with unsharp, you can make the color areas bigger and bleed, you know, into one another, the colors, I mean. And, you make images that show emotions and feelings and not, you know, a subject. That's usually what we do. We photograph a person or something. But what about if we just make unsharp images and photograph colors and shadows and light that blend into each other because of the unsharpness? That could be a revelation to try that and see how also visually interesting images you have that evoke emotions. And one way of doing this is making multiple exposures. If your camera has the ability to make multiple exposures, why not blend two images together and make an interesting image in camera? Or you can also blend images together in Photoshop using layers. That's another way of doing it. Atmospheric effects. Capturing scenes in different weather conditions like fog, rain, or mist can add an ethereal expressionistic quality to street photographs. Use mist filters. Different type of mist filters are quite new. We used to call them soft focus back in the day, but mist filters are filters that will make the edges of bright lights a lot softer, so it will give a more atmosphere to your images, kind of like a fog or something like that. And that will also take out the digital look from your images, and it will also make the image slightly unsharp and to be look more like impressionistic image. Experiment with these and see how that affect your image, and does it give you a more moody atmospheric look, which is towards the impressionistic approach. And then fun fact about impressionistic movement in paintings. It was made possible because the invention of paint tube. That made the painters be able to go outside and see for themselves and paint while they're looking at the scene. Before that, they had to be in a studio indoors because they could not take their paints out. But with the tube, it was possible to go out and experiment the light as it happens. Loose compositions. Instead of adhering to strict composition rules, this style may favor a more spontaneous, intuitive arrangement of elements within the frame, focusing, evoking a feeling or an atmosphere. And here again, we're talking about the feeling and the atmosphere. So break the rules of composition and try to, you know, do something different. Like I always have said, that a perfect composition is nice. Yeah, it's a pretty image, but most likely it won't be that interesting unless there is a small mistake in the composition, which will make the image more interesting and start our thinking process in our brains. Emphasis on subjective experiences. This style crucially relies on the photographer's personal impression and emotion response to the scene. The aim is often to capture a sense of place or a moment in time as experienced by the photographer, rather than provide a clear objective record of the scene. And yeah, this is something that we need to do when we're photographing images with like evoking emotions, is that we have to put ourselves 100% into the situation. It's not about just recording and documenting as the things are, but the photographer's interpretation of the scene. And we want to tell stories, we want to tell our stories, and of course the story that the viewer sees might be different. It doesn't matter. If it raises emotions and makes the viewer think, then it is a good image. And then selective focus. This is something that we can do. We can use a wide aperture to make the background blur and make it more impressionistic. You know, color palette things that are out of focus. Wisely used, shallow depth of field is a very powerful way of making the image. But always remember that in street photography, we also want to show the environment as much as possible. So this is a kind of like a contradictory thing, what we usually think about street photographs. But if we want to make an impressionistic image, this could be one way of doing, just using your lens wide open and see what happens. And a reminder, before we get into the tip number 7, I will have an extra tip after that. Post-processing techniques. And this is very important in any image, the post-processing and the ability to understand that it's really important. And for example, in impressionistic images, we could do, like I already said, overlays and textures to the images, or multiple exposures done in post. Or we can use the clarity slider to make everything a bit blurry, or we could use a Gaussian blur to make everything out of focus or something like that. And that also could make the image look impressionistic. The using of texture overlays is something that will make the painterly look to an image.
And a tip, you can photograph your overlays and textures yourself. Concrete materials or any material can be used as an overlay. So when you see some interesting texture on a wall, photograph it and use it as a layer on top of your image to make it more impressionistic. That's a really good way. But let's continue.
And then the extra tip, window reflections. Pretty close to multiple exposure, but window reflections can make really abstract and impressionistic images if you have motion blur and movement in the image too. That's a good way. And, you know, it's easy to find these reflections because they are everywhere in cities. Windows, really shiny walls or whatever. And why I find this impressionistic style interesting is that it's kind of a opposite in a way to the classical street photographs, which usually are really pin sharp from front to back, a lot of depth of field, in other words. And this kind of contradicts all that. And that's why I think experimenting with impressionistic images in the streets is really interesting because it's kind of opens our minds and things or makes things a bit differently. And here is that video about going deep. But hey, thanks for watching and bye for now.